Yes, Kaby Lake is here, and with it, a lot of expectations. The 7th generation of Intel processors is supposed to be the dream of any respectable gamers. The i7-7700k is supposed to have unparalleled overclocking abilities, and of course, we are not going to take their word for it, are we? Alright, let's install it. Here is our CPU close-up. Back on the motherboard, here is a CPU shield, and on the left, the levier. To open your CPU hatch, simply pull it toward the left and let it go up. It will give place to your CPU holder. Basically, this is where your CPU will sit, and please beware of the pins on its surface. As usual, don't touch any of them. They are very sensitive, and if any one of them are bent, well, get yourself a new motherboard. Now, let's take a closer look on how I placed the CPU. Usually, the motherboard shows a triangle, which matches the direction of the golden pyramid on your processor. But for some reason, this is not our case. The only way we can make sure that the processor is correctly sited is thanks to those two little notches on its side. So be extra careful at this stage of the build. Now that this is done, we are simply going to put back in place the hatch and closing down the levier. Make sure to place it back under the CPU holder bracket, and you will see that the plastic CPU shield should pop right out. Installing RAM on this motherboard is easy. We have a typical dual channel configuration, which can accept up to 64 GB of RAM and up to 16 GB per memory stick. The only thing you should do is to respect the channel order. For example, if you have only one stick of RAM, you want to put it in the A2 slot. If you have two of them, A2 and B2. The A1 channel will be for your third memory stick, and the B1 channel for your fourth and final memory stick. If you don't respect the memory order, then your motherboard will give you a RAM error when you try to boot it up. Now, time to put our RAM module in place. Make sure first to remove all the little plastic stickers which protect the engraved name on your memory stick, and make sure that they are in the right direction. A little notch on your memory stick should help you do that. And now simply slide it into place and apply the same amount of pressure first on one side of your memory stick and then on the other. This should lock it right into place.